Did you hear that? Today on the Roof Property Show, we're going to be showing you how to use the right hardware, which one should you use for floor trusses so you don't get that squeak in your house. Let's get started. All right, so this home has a subfloor, as you can see down below me here, and I'm walking around right now, just moving a little bit of pressure here on the floor, and you hear this rattling behind me. It's kind of squeak. That is an actual truss clip. It's a Simpson truss clip, and what that is designed for, it's actually designed to go on roof trusses, not on floor trusses. And this was actually placed up here, which we'll look at. You can see it's actually on the gang nail. It sits on a non-bearing interior wall, so it's designed to actually tie together the non-bearing wall so it's not going back and forth. So it secures the top of that to the floor truss. And the floor trusses are designed to actually go over the top of these interior walls and not bear down, because this floor system is not designed to take a load. So Simpson recommends do not put these on the floor trusses. Instead, they're recommending to use an SDPW deflector screw. And I'm going to show you how this is actually installed. You can see what they're made to do. But this allows for this wall to get tied off, and then it also allows for the deflection either going up or down on your floor system, and it eliminates the squeaks. So I put one of these in here so you could actually see what a truss clip does instead of the deflector screw that you should be using. So now these truss clips, the actual number on these is an STC-R. There's a couple different sizes of these, but essentially this slot sits, this sits on top of the wall. It gets two screws in it. And then this has a, you can put a screw or a nail in this, and this slides up or slides down. You don't tighten that nail tight on here. So we'll show you that up top. And then I'll show you how this is actually installed and how this actually works. So this is what a truss clip looks like. This is actually secured to the top plate here. You got the SDS screws, and you have one that runs in here, and this goes into the actual side of the truss. Now this truss, so there's another problem here. This wall got actually framed too tall, and this truss is designed to go all the way over the top. And this should have like a half inch gap, 3/4 inch gap right here between this wall. So this truss can deflect up or down. So, but the movement and the noise that you're hearing is this movement right here of this truss clip on this gang nail, and also possibly this screw right here. So if you were to actually have, you know, movement up or down, this should move up, or when you, from weight from above, you pull down and it causes this truss to deflect down. So you want this space in here to allow this to come down. But the squeaking is occurring from these truss clips. There's another one right over here that you can see. And see how that's not tight? So that's what you want typically on a roof truss clip. While you're putting this on a roof truss, that's what you want. And this doesn't have room to come down. So there's two issues here: truss clip on a floor truss, and also not enough space from the bottom of the truss to the top of the wall. So this wall, another way you could fix this is actually frame this with an inch and a half plate, or like a 2x plate here, and then maybe go 1x plate on top to eliminate this from happening. So what we're gonna use and we're gonna look at is this SDPD deflector screw. And you can see out here, and it comes in boxes of 50s. You can get them in a 3.5 inch, a 5 inch, or a 6 inch. So you have to look at what the thickness of your top plates are. So we're actually moving the floor down below right now. Someone's stepping on the floor, and you can see this screw moving in the slot, and that's what's causing the squeak on this truss. So that's solved with this deflector screw. So when I was talking about the top plates, the thickness of the top plates, you can see this here. This is showing a top plate here, like a single top plate, and then you have your gap between the truss, the bottom of the truss and the top plate, and this is going in. So this is actually showing what a 3.5 inch single top plate, that 3.5 inch deflector screw will work on this. If you go to the 5 inch, you can get this is a 2x top plate with a 1x top plate, then you have your gap, and then you have the bottom of your truss. And then you have, this says anywhere from a 0 to 1.5 inch gap between these trusses. So here on a double top plate, if you have two, this would be 3 inches, and then you have a 0 to 1.5 inch gap, and then you can run this to the bottom of the truss. It's a 6 inch screw. So that's how you want to look at this as far as the figuring out what length deflector screw you want to actually order. So the way these things work is you got a, this is, there's an actual screw inside of like a polymer sleeve that's here. And the first thing you do is you get a 3/8 bit, and this actually comes in the box, and you pre-drill. So you're gonna actually come in here and drill through the top plate up through. And we'll put one of these in so you can see it in just a second. But essentially you're gonna drill a hole, And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna grab one of these offset bits. This is a 3/4 inch offset bit. So what it does is it, if you look inside here, take a look at this here, that bit is actually down only into there that far. So it's not gonna drive this, this head's not gonna get driven tight to the bottom of the bottom plate. So if you look up here, we have a couple of these installed already. You can see this here, where that's down about 3/4 of an inch. I actually tightened those up just a little bit more just so you can see them, because this doesn't need to move that much on the floor, the full 3/4 of an inch, and I wanted to get a little bit more into the truss up above. But you can see how this is made to work. So if you don't want to have the full depth down, like the 3/4 of an inch of the screwed head down, you only need like a 1/2 inch or so, you could just take and just get a T25 bit just like this and just run it in and leave it a 1/2 inch down, and it works just the same. But both of these, the 3/8 bit, and then you also get this driver that comes with it, that's in the box. Each box has one of these for doing what you need to do. So they have an extension bit here that you can actually take and run up, so it makes it easier. So when you're down here, you can just take and just go up and in, and you don't have to get on a ladder. It makes it a lot faster for installation. All right, so I'm gonna jump up now. I'm just gonna show you how to put this in really quick. It's pretty easy and goes really quick. So first step, 3/8 bit, we're gonna put that thing in. We're gonna go try to center between the top plate. So find the center of your top plate, center of the truss that's coming down underneath here. One thing you can run into, there's certain scenarios where maybe this you'd have a double stud right underneath this. That can create a challenge for this. Most of the time you can get an angle or right up against a stud, get an angle up into there, into the truss, and that'll help you to get it in. So you haven't run into too many issues with that, but this, you're gonna come up in here, you're gonna drill. So you're gonna make sure that you do not go through into the truss. So you're gonna stop that. Once you go, you're gonna make sure you go through the top of the plate, and then right before you get to the truss, right as you go through the top of the plate, you're gonna stop that so you don't go into the truss. You do not wanna drill through the truss. So once that's in there, all you do, take this here, drop it back down, make sure it's on your bit, put that in the hole. That's it. And it's in there just like that. So listen to this again. This is gonna squeak, and then I'm gonna go up there, I'm gonna take that truss clip off, and we're gonna get rid of that squeak. So listen to this. Hear the squeak? Okay, now I'm gonna get up here, I'm gonna pull this truss clip off. So now we have the truss clips off. I'm gonna go down, and I'm actually gonna move on the floor here, and we're gonna see if this thing got rid of our squeak. Gone. Squeak is gone. So by removing that truss clip and putting that deflector screw in there, we've eliminated the squeak on the floor truss. So that will save you a lot of callbacks, not having to have someone call you, hey, my floor is squeaking. Imagine having to cut that open and then have to get in there and actually fix it. Okay, so this truss here, it has about 1/4 of an inch in between it. It could use more as well. The deflection from the floor up top is not that significant, so we're clear. You can get a good idea here of how this deflector screw works if I hang on this. So say I'm applying a load to the top of this floor truss, you can see this deflector screw come down about 1/8 of an inch. So just by my weight pulling down on this, and that's what this is made to do. You didn't hear any squeaking or anything else going on. So that's the idea behind these deflector screws. You can use these as well on roof trusses if you would like. However, the roof truss just doesn't move enough, and you just don't get those squeaks from people walking on it all the time. All right, well, I hope you learned something about these Simpson deflector screws and how they can help you eliminate the floor squeaks if you're using floor trusses and getting those callbacks from homeowners that are calling you. So if you would like more information about building a custom home or an ADU, visit our website at freemansconstruction.com. If you'd like information about how we can help you with buying or selling your home or land, visit our website at freemansrealty.com. Thanks again for watching.